I'm Bob Horton, Director of Library Publications and Collections at the Minnesota Historical Society. We're on level B of the society in the artifact storage area, and this is an item in our collection. Do you have any idea what it might be? We can notice the large wheel, the gear, electric motor, wires, seemingly made out of pig iron, immensely big. Looks like something that come from the set of a Frankenstein movie, but in fact, it's a hard drive, an early hard drive developed in 1946 with what was then the astonishing storage capacity of 23 kilobytes. You all have socks that are smarter than this today. And we know how to preserve this as an artifact, as an object. The challenge that we're facing and the challenge that everybody who's dealing with technology and computers and all the decades since 1946 is how to preserve the information it's stored. How do we capture, store, and provide access to the historically valuable digital content created all over the world in the past several decades? Nobody has a solid, proven, adaptable model for us to follow. We all hear a lot about the problem, and the solution is really critical to the survival of libraries, museums, and archives in the 21st century. This is the sort of content that our patrons are going to want to use. What we don't often hear, though, is that this really isn't a new problem. Virtually every communications medium developed in the 20th century presented us with pretty much the same problems. Let's look at a few examples and learn more about it. Here are some of the digital content storage solutions we've run into as we've collected different things. This is I'm not actually sure what this is, some sort of version of a punch card with a magnetic tape quality. We would have no idea what's on there, or even, frankly, where to go to find out. And then just in most our recent experiences with computers, we've seen a tremendous variety of different storage media. This is a flat 5 1/4 inch floppy disk, has the enormous storage capacity of 360 kilobytes. iPhone, what, 8 gigabytes, 16 gigabytes? An enormous variation. We're now have gone from a situation where this, something this size, is carrying 250 megabytes, something this size, more like 8 to 16 gigabytes, and all the applications that goes along with it. That's an enormous set of challenges for an organization like ours. How do we capture material from all these different types of storage media? How do we deal with all the different applications that are being developed to use them? They're all changing. If we've experienced change like this, or like this, in just the past 50 years, and haven't really gotten on top of it, how do we predict what the next 2 years, 5 years, or 10 years are going to be like? Even if we had the resources, where do we invest them to make sure we're going to get the biggest return? How do we know that we've picked the right technology? All that we really do know is that people have had a pretty bad track record of predicting the future. So we can come to some interesting, if not terribly exciting, conclusions. In all the cases we're looking at, whether it's a digital content or audio content or video content developed over the past decades, if you want to keep the material useful, if you want to retain access to the content, we know the basic formula is the same. Capture the information, migrate it to new media as new media is developed, convert it to the new applications and formats that provide access to it. But start thinking about the complications. The quantities we're talking about are huge. And contrary to what you hear, storage isn't really cheap. Yes, you can go to a store and buy a 1 gigabyte thumb drive, which costs practically nothing now. You can probably get it free at a lot of conferences and meetings if you attend that sort of thing. That's great for you. That's great for your individual routine. But start to think about a situation like ours. The Minnesota Historical Society works with state and local government. It works with millions of citizens. It works with large companies. It works with virtually everybody in the state and the region at some level. And they are all creating information on a huge scale, an industrial scale, vast, vast quantities of digital content. It's not cheap for us to do that. And the moral is, the content is being produced on that huge industrial scale, and the preservation is being handled here by a relatively small number of people on a boutique or artisan scale, very different level of volume. So as we look ahead, as we start to deal at the Historical Society with the challenges of managing digital content into the future, we're open to suggestions. You've heard a few ideas from us, gotten some idea of the problems. Let us know what you think we should do. Send us your ideas, send us your recommendations, and we'll take a look at them on our blog. Thank you for your time. I'm Bob Horton from the Minnesota Historical Society.